protect me from yourself.
Protect yourself from yourself.
James, let's just take you back to the weekend. And this is Trending SA right here on SABC3. Don't forget that you can catch us on TrendingSA.tv. You're going to check out a tweet right now. And this is what you have to say to us. This one from Lindy Wet. Dali saying, I can't wait to see Mlindo RSA. I love his music and his hashtag Emakhaya album is everything. I agree with you on this one. Very quickly, it's a tweet, but I know it's not on air. I saw it now during the ad break. Mpo is celebrating her birthday today. So just a very quick happy birthday to Mpo, okay?
How do you say it?
Mpo. Mpo. All right, ready? One and a two. And a one, two, three, let's go.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Mpo. Happy birthday to you.
Thank you for your post. Hope you enjoyed your birthday. Time now to know what Pearls got for us.
So to kickstart today's update, hashtag Omotoso trial trended again today as the rape trial against Nigerian pastor Timothy Omotoso continued at the Eastern Cape High Court. So today, Omotoso's lawyer, Peter Doberman, requested that the presiding officer, Judge Mandela Magwaula, to recuse himself from the case, basing their reasons on that the judge had showed too much sympathy for the first state witness, Usheryl Zondi, who took the stand last week. So I thought we should look at the basis of the defense's reasons behind their request for the judge to excuse himself from the case, right? Firstly, in judicial proceedings, recusal is the stepping aside or disqualification of a judicial officer from a case on the grounds of personal interest. It could be bias, prejudice, or conflict of interest, or if he or she has conducted him or herself in a manner that could compromise their ruling. Now, here's what Omotoso's defense argument about Judge Magwaula's behavior during the trial had, right? In an affidavit read out in court, Omotoso said that Magwaula's comments, wishing state witness Cheryl Zondi well for her exams, was biased against him. Did Judge Magwaula cross the line by wishing the state witness Cheryl Zondi well for her exams? What do you guys think?
It's that time of the year. I mean, she's going to write matric, so obviously it makes sense to wish her. You know, the defense is reaching.
Well, he's a judge. He's supposed to be neutral. It did seem
he didn't write the exam for her. He just said good luck.
Exactly. Look, I think this had many little elements. So throughout the cross-examination of Cheryl, you see a lot of like him coming to her defense quite a lot. So in the little things that he was doing, telling the defense to like calm down or tone it down, you know, in the little things, I think there were bits that showed some element of bias or some element of being emotional towards what the prosecution was presenting or how the prosecution was defending themselves. So
the problem with that actually, and the fact that he could be showing bias actually jeopardizes her. So he might think that he's doing her a favor. You got to be cruel to be kind in a situation like this. You've got to remain completely objective, because they could appeal, ask for a new judge. She'll have to go through that and probably worse again. So I don't think that he's doing her any favors by showing her favoritism in the space.
And you know, there were like seven different newspapers reporting on the fact that she got a lot of death threats. So there could be a point there.
Oh, geez. Sure. And another claim is that the judge was too sympathetic towards the witness, according to the affidavit read in court, Omotoso claims. And I quote, the presiding officer has already made up his mind. He is sympathetic towards Zondi and her cause. He identified with and aligned himself to Zondi's cause. Now, here's an example of how Judge Magwaula handled himself during the cross-examination of Cheryl Zondi. Take a look at this.
Painfully over every detail of her assault.
How many centimeters? You know?
How can he measure?
My lord, she could have felt it.
How would he know that? How many centimeters? How would he know that? How would she know that?
She could have felt it.
And then measure it at the same time. My lord, I would not have.
So he was clearly protecting her in that video. Do you still think he wasn't being biased, Kuli?
I just think that her useless lawyer was probably like taking a selfie, should have actually defended her there. And because he wasn't, the judge, you know, thought, you know, let me just step in here. Of course, he could have said objection. But the point is that the lawyer should have been paying more attention. And also, you know, it's such a sensitive manner. It's such a sensitive case. That's why I think that the judge might be seen to be.
Yeah, right. I think you have a point there in terms of what the prosecution wants to do. So in as much as it plays to our emotional sides when we watch the judge also agree on the point. But the prosecution is to try have a case that's so good that no one comes in and tries to poke holes in it, like have appeals or try change a judge. Because today, the judge did say, no, I'm not going to recuse myself. But then that just leaves them to continue with the trial. And at the end, after he theoretically is found guilty, they can come back and say, nope. We felt that there was bias there. They appeal. He goes out on bail. Mm. And then many things can happen when you're out on bail. So let's just be very aware of that, I think.
Look, there's so many things that I want to say. The defense lawyer should have been doing his job. The defense lawyer, I mean, this Doberman guy, I mean, he's trying to do his job. He's trying to break her down as a character witness. Mm-hmm. But he should have been stopped by the prosecution for badgering and things like that. I mean, yeah. But what can we do? Anyway. They need a better lawyer.
Yep, they do. Anyway, Judge Makaula has dismissed Omotoso's application to recuse himself. Now we have to wait and see what the outcome will be. But for now, let's move on to another trending topic. Another hashtag that burst up on my timeline today was hashtag SARS Inquiry. This is after the Nugent Commission of Inquiry kicked off for a third round of public hearings today. President Cyril Ramaphosa has appointed former Judge Robert Nugent to head the Tax Administration Commission of Inquiry. The commission is expected to consider the adequacy and legality of steps that SARS took to address revenue shortfalls in the past 2 years, including unauthorized bonuses to top executives and various tax administration processes. However, it is the SARS Digital Information Systems Technology Chief Officer. What was that, Kuli?
Shocked.
Mamate Makhehe Mokwane, who had created more of a storm with her hashtag protect me from yourself remarks during an interview. She has since apologized for her behavior and demeanor. And during that very awkward morning live interview, Makeke Mokwane was asked about what needs to be done to fix SARS's IT infrastructure. And her answer became what viral videos are made of. Take a look at this.
I would want to insult those people at the moment because their children would benefit from a SARS bursary system.
But talking about the IT restructuring, ma'am,
can you give me protection from yourself?
But we're talking.
Wow! What do you guys think of the video?
Is it English not our first language?
No, the thing is,
no.
It sounds like sobriety is not her first language.
Wow. I think this is the truth, that people are sick and tired of being politicked into things. By that, I mean, you give them the political answer. So we ask you, how was your day, Pearl? And when are you going to do your homework? And Pearl says, it's important as a nation that we face the struggles that, no. Yeah. People don't want to hear that anymore. Mm. We ask you a direct question. We want a direct answer. And people are getting more and more frustrated with politicians not answering questions or doing what they say they're going to do.
Stop giving us the Steve Compella answer. Give us the answer.
I'm just concerned that something might be wrong.
Yeah?
Do you know what I mean? I mean, no one would like self-sabotage themselves like that.
I'm still stuck on the Steve Compella answer thing. Really, you had to take it there. In true hustler style, people took, of course, the opportunity to cash in on the trending topic. Songs were recorded as well as t-shirts designed.
Wow.
With the now famous line, hashtag protect me from yourself. Look at this one from Jacques_Shark. Hashtag protect me from yourself.
You know what I did like though, and I did like the fact that she did apologize and she gave no excuses.
Yeah.
She says there's no excuse for my behavior and I apologize unconditionally. Yeah,
can I tell you one question that I wanted as you come join us back here?
Yeah.
Is that I was just waiting for the journalist to ask one simple question. To say, ma'am, look into the screen and say, ma'am, what does IT mean? And I wanted to hear what the answer was going to be. Because a lot of the time, people are in positions that they really shouldn't be in. And it makes it very tricky when things happen. And anyway, moving on though, it's time for us to take a look at what we believe is the next big movie to hit our timeline soon. Now, I saw this thing, and it's called Waar is die Prankie? It stars Ace Magashule, Ricardo Mettler, and The Hawks.
What's a prankie?
It's a picture.
Okay.
Or a painting, or some art. All right. This summer, one man, and one man only, the ANC Secretary General, Ace Magashule, has to prove his innocence after being implicated at the center of a criminal investigation. But what is the crime? Who is the crime? Where is the crime? Was he involved in the great cash heist? Was he involved in the Gupta scandals? Is he hiding the Guptas? Is he a Gupta? No. Officials believe that Ace Magashule is the man behind the disappearance of an 8 million rand painting. That is not just any painting, but a J.H. Birniev painting.
It all started earlier this year in 2018 when then Free State Premier Ace Magashule got a new job and had to vacate his office in the Free State to assume his new role as the ruling party Secretary General. Life was great. Life was grand. But then, a dark cloud hovered over the office. It was discovered that in the midst of the move, the painting went missing. This led the people to be asking, "Waar is die prankie?" Has the painting belonged to the provincial government?
Hot at the scene are the Hawks, who are also identified as new. Who have also identified a new suspect. Some call him Rix, some call him Ricardo, but in this case, he is Ricardo Mettler, who is believed to be Magashule's security detail, and he's said to be close to the former premier. Question is he close enough to steal a painting for him? Ricardo Mettler admitted to receiving the painting as a gift from Magashule at the former premier's house after it accidentally landed up in his personal belongings. Question is, why would Magashule give Ricardo the painting as a gift?
The painting was then given to a local businessman who has not yet been identified, who in turn asked auctioneers to help him determine the artwork's value. The auctioneer placed an advertisement publicizing the Pirniev, which drew the attention of the Free State authorities, who then discovered the artwork was missing.
Oh my gosh.
Will Ace Magashule rise above all this? Will the painting be found? Was it truly an error? Well, all of this is coming soon to a timeline near you in a movie called Waar is die Prankie?
Skrskr!
Yeah! Guys, did you hear about that movie?
My gosh, I can't wait.
But that was quite a dumb movie. You know, you don't know where you got it from, and then suddenly you're asking people to appraise it. I mean, come on, find out where you got it from first.
This is all criminality, and it needs to be dealt with accordingly. And accordingly, we're going to go for an ad break right now. When we come back, Mlindo de Vocalist!
Did you hear the drop? That voice?